house of God one more time. As someone said, every time I turn around, he keeps on blessing
us.
And God is still in the blessing business in our hearts. It's going on in our nation. The Lord is still good. Continue to pray for our sick and our shut in. And don't forget the funeral services for our brother. More on tomorrow. The week is at 10, followed by our morning service at 11. I'm going to go ahead and write on the board for you tonight. It's good to see our officers and members here in the house of God.
Yes, sir.
I'm afraid that, when this is over, many people will become.
Yes, they will. They already
comfortable.
They already there.
You stay at home.
They already there.
And I said all the time when Jesus was born, it was a difficult time then. But through it all, the Lord took care of him.
Amen.
And the Lord will take care of us.
Amen.
Tonight, I want to talk about tonight. Mm-hmm. I want to be able to share with us about something that we need to really trust God for.
Amen. Gotta have it.
Right on the board, we don't trust God enough. Underneath that, we don't thank him.
That's right, Pastor.
Enough. Ephesians 5, verses 15 through 20, where a lesson will come from the night. And our theme will be always giving thanks. Always giving thanks.
We know that he's there.
You cannot doubt God.
Mm-hmm.
Even the thing that we're facing, you cannot doubt.
Oh, help us now.
Whether God is in charge.
Amen.
You cannot doubt whether God cares everything. That God cares for us. Everything that He woke us up this morning.
Amen.
Clothed us in our right mind. Just looking at Conley West. And it could be either one of us.
Right.
But we need to be careful with the gifts, the talent that God has shared with us.
Yes,
you know that right?
Yes,
there are some people who are doing all they can.
Oh, have mercy, Lord.
Not to catch the virus.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
They're doing all they can to keep from catching. And it seems like they're the one that's catching.
Amen.
This is an age where we have to be careful, we have to be prayerful,
yes,
and we have to trust God, knowing
yes,
that, that God is still in charge.
Amen.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
And so he says, that's easier to give God thanks.
That's right.
And to speak of God's goodness in the midst of good times. Is that right?
Yeah,
let the good time roll.
Oh, yeah.
But when trouble invades our home, we become bitter.
Mercy.
And nonchalant and do everything else. But even in the midst of our houses burning down, even in the midst of being evicted, we still got to trust God.
Yeah.
We still got to know that God is still in charge.
Yeah.
Is that right? When we're having our worship, granted, and everything is going our way. Is that right? We can trust God.
Say it now.
But we must realize that we are to thank God for everything else.
Amen.
I discovered that trouble is not so bad if you got the right person on board with you.
Say that now.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
See, you, brother, Lord, you can go to sleep.
Like we often say that about that joy will come in the morning, but sometimes it don't come in the morning, Pastor. Sometimes after the Lord, I prolong your time. Take for instance, you guys, it was a long time before you got back in the pulpit, but you never gave up.
Never
gave up. You kept on fasting all three churches. You kept right on issuing out orders. You kept on doing what you normally would be doing. When sometimes we'll holler real loud in the first half, I know the Lord will wait, but let it linger for a while,
no.
And we'll lose our faith.
Yeah. If it lingers too long. I wonder why would you call somebody that's already don't want to be in church?
Have mercy.
That's it. All right.
I just said something.
Yeah.
That if anybody gets sick, they'll lay the blame on the church. I didn't tell you I went to the nightclub. I didn't tell you I stopped by the one on the back.
No.
I didn't tell you I went to Walmart and Kmart and all the other ones.
I know you right there. I know you right there.
There comes a time in our lives that we need to keep our mouths shut and don't talk to negative people.
That's right.
Negative people will have you behaving just like they do.
Yes, like you.
Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
And some folks, you got to give them an eviction notice.
Right.
Sometimes you call people and you have to be careful before you ask them how they feel, because they got a long, long story. But somewhere down the line, you get to the point that I'm going to thank God anyhow.
Right now.
Because it could be worse.
Could be worse.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
And so we got to thank God.
Oh, yeah.
For everything.
Everything.
The Apostle Paul tells us in Ephesians 5 to give thanks to God. We got to give thanks.
That's
To the right person.
Amen.
And the right person to give thanks is God.
Amen.
He rules and super rules.
Amen.
You're right.
Isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
And as they say, that he got the whole world
Amen.
In his hand.
Amen.
Yes, he does.
I'm not going to let nobody turn me around.
Amen.
No, sir.
I know too much about him. I've seen him.
Amen.
I've seen him perform miracles. I've seen him when it looked awful bad that God stepped right in
Amen.
And gave us victory.
Amen.
Right.
Why should I turn to God?
Amen, Father.
That is a protector, that is a redeemer. Mm. Is that right?
Yes.
Listen what 1 Thessalonians 5 and 18 says. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 18. 5 and 18 says,
In everything,
give thanks.
For this is the will of God.
This is the will of God. And you got to learn, don't try to change God's
Amen.
Will, but whatever his will is,
Amen.
Let it be done.
Amen.
Read that again, sister.
In everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you.
This for you. In everything, give thanks.
Amen.
I know my house is running down, but I'm saying, thank God. Thank you, man. I know that I'm facing the judge tomorrow, but I'm still going to thank God.
Amen.
You love me?
Yes, amen.
And because when God gets through with us, we're going to come forward as pure gold.
Amen.
This is what he says in the 15th verse. See that none render evil. It's some evil folks in the world. And sometimes we find them right in our church.
Amen, Father.
They're saying some hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down, I feel better. But them same folk will curse you out if you're not careful. I don't want to be a complainer all the time. I want the church to see me happy.
Amen.
I want the world to understand that even though trouble invades our lives, but it's got to get better.
Amen.
He said, now, see that none render evil. Sometimes people in church want the pastor to set some people down and put them out. And I really want to tell them, baby, you're the one that needs to leave the church. Because if it was really left up to some of us, would nobody be in church. You run them away. If you're present in that choir, you're so mean and evil, there ain't nobody in the choir but you. Are you with me? And so the pastor has to plead and beg that everybody do what's right.
Amen.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
For evil unto any man, but ever following that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. There are some people can't get along with themselves. I never seen people who say, I'm saved and I'm sanctified, but I can't work with nobody. No. If you're born again, you ought to be willing to share the Lord. If you're so intelligent, you ought to want to help somebody else come up to where you are. You want to set out by yourself like you know everything. And usually, you're the only big fool there. Are you with me? Verse 16, rejoice evermore. Rejoice. Get up happy. The mere fact that God kept you last night, woke you up, you were able to feel yourselves and clothed in the right mind. Lord, I thank you. I don't know what the evening, what the day gonna bring, but I thank you for what you've already done.
Amen.
Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing.
That's right.
And then he says in 18 verse, everything. Give thanks. But this is the will of God in Christ Jesus. Concerning you.
That's right.
You that right? We got to learn to thank God.
Amen.
Thank him in the morning. Thank him in the
week. That's right.
Thank him throughout.
That's right.
The day.
Amen.
Well, another reason that we ought to thank God. Another reason that we ought to thank God is because we know that God cares for us.
Mm-hmm.
He cares for us. Even while we're sleeping, the Lord is working in our behalf.
Thank you, Jesus.
Every day he loads us up
daily
with blessings daily.
Yes, he does.
We got clothes in our closet that we won't even wear this year.
Yeah, you sure right
wow.
There.
No.
You sure not right.
And we got to learn how to share.
Mm-hmm.
See?
That's it, Pastor.
And when you learn how to share, God opened up some more windows for something to get into you.
That's right.
But if you keep your hand to it, that which is in there gonna get out and nothing gets in. Is that right?
That's a fact.
It says here that we are instructed by the Apostle Paul to give thanks.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Mom. Mama didn't have to tell us that to say the blessing. We knew that when we sat down to the table,
that's right,
that somebody was going to say grace and somebody was going to say grace. And you couldn't say Jesus wept every single
time.
But Jesus wept. He's tired of crying. Yeah. Now, you don't wait till they get 12, 15, and 20 years old, and then want to teach them. You got to start training them while they're young. Is that right?
That's right.
Because we know that God cares. God knows every part of our lives.
Amen.
Yes, he does.
And then the beautiful part about him, he cares about every part of it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I hear you thinking, you say, well, if God cares, why does bad things happen? The good people.
Teach now, Pastor. Teach now.
Y'all remember Job was a perfect man.
Yes, sir.
One that lived an upright life.
That's right.
One that paid tithe for his sons and daughters.
Yes, he did.
Is that right?
That's right.
And Job was minding his own business. And Satan came one day, and the Lord said, Satan, where you been? He said, I've been going to and fro, seeking whom I made the time. Satan wants you.
Uh-huh.
He wants you to make he wants to make you think that coming to church is useless. You can't make it without the church.
Say it now.
You know that?
That's it.
Look at all the people right in Chicago.
Mm.
You can't have a funeral peacefully.
Yeah.
24 people shot. And that's why I say all the time that you need to be careful who you invite to sit in your yard.
Say it now.
You may be innocent, but here comes Fred.
That's
Fred,
right.
Fred just started a fight across
amen.
The
amen.
Yes,
that's right.
So you got to sometimes stand at the door and example everybody that comes in. Look like you do. When you go to the hospital now, they look like they're going to shoot you and they're taking your temperature. Take them down, look at, see what they got in their pocket. These folks are at a funeral.
Yeah,
but when they start shooting in, they start shooting out.
Oh, man.
Are you with me? And that's why we put emphasis on that you got to be careful.
Yes, sir.
Just turning the church over to the hands of sinners.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
The house is to be respected.
That's right.
And some folk will come right off the street with their heads on, with a big old garbage bag on their back.
Uh-huh.
You going to church, fix up.
That's right, God.
And sometimes our own mothers and fathers are fearful of us. Yeah. So he says here, if God cares, then why do bad things happen? Right on the board that God allows sin. Yeah. God allows sin. Number two, God gave Satan permission.
That's right. Yes, he did. Permission.
The church jewel.
Mm-hmm.
See, the Lord knows who we get trouble.
Amen.
And sometimes God sends you through things that you might be better when you get through going through.
Amen.
This is no out of patience for you to be crying and going on.
Amen, God.
If you're going to be saved, if you're going to be rooted and grounded in the Word of God, you got to be able to take some.
Amen.
I'm leaving the church because somebody didn't talk to me. And they even cursed you out talking about your mama and your brothers.
That's right.
And you still there. But only at the church.
Only at the church.
Where we're looking for an excuse.
That's it right there.
Not to come.
Amen.
I wonder how many of us would have took God at his word when God told Hosea to go down there and marry a prostitute.
How many questions we would have threw at God
yeah. instead of just going to it.
Most of us would have said, Lord, you must be out of your mind. I'm a choir member. I'm a deacon. I'm a trustee. I'm a preacher. And you're talking about me married.
And he had a purpose, brother.
Had a purpose.
Wanted Hosea to know how you feel about us.
Yeah. The Lord wanted Hosea to know how he felt when people rejected him.
Yes.
And you act like this is the first time that people have been rejected.
Have mercy.
Be strong.
Amen.
In the Lord and the power of his might.
Satan is out to get you.
Oh, yes, Pastor.
He's busy.
He don't like when you smile.
Amen.
No. And don't let, if you talk to these negative people long enough, You will find yourself complaining too. Child, my nigga said. You can't turn your nigga around at 7 years old like you was when you was 15.
Amen.
And while you're turning your neck, you got to say, Lord, thank you. Because some people can turn that neck and don't feel no pain. We live in a fallen and sinful world. We live in a fallen and sinful world. The world today is not designed like God designed it.
No.
He wanted us to have fellowship. He wanted us to be together. And most folks in all of our churches across America, when Sunday morning comes, before you give the benediction, they got the keys in their hand, ready?
Amen.
You got to learn how to fellowship.
Uh-huh.
Don't come to church in a hurry. We as pastors have somewhat messed up our You trying to let Brother Dunnell out. Brother Dunnell ain't gonna be here in the freight bed. He won't go. Let him go. But there's somebody else who wants to be here, who wants to hear the word. Right. And so, this is a sinful world, a fallen society. However, we can still be thankful. Because he suffered with us, and he promised us victory. Is that right?
That's right.
This is what Ephesians 5:8.
For ye were sometimes darkness.
In the dark. But now you're light. You're let your light shine.
That's right, Father.
You got no business about your eyes. I'm saved, I'm sanctified. And they see you going to the liquor store.
Oh, my goodness.
They see you cussing out people. They say, saved folks.
Saved folks.
Are peculiar love people.
Amen, Father.
Pastor, I talked to three people today in Woodford that's out of Kalamazoo up there. Their church has been closed ever since their epidemic, and two of the people saying that they are getting weak because they know themselves they're doing some things that they weren't doing before, simply because they haven't been in church.
You can't help them to get weak.
That's right.
You know, when I read my Bible at home, you got the radio on, you got the dog jumping in your lap.
They admitted that themselves.
Say what?
They admitted that to me.
They admitted that.
That they noticed themselves that they're getting weak.
Yeah.
You get weak. Take your foot off of the accelerator. You're driving 50 miles an hour. But take your foot off of the accelerator, and eventually you're going to slow down to zero.
Amen.
You ain't that strong that you can stay away from the church. The Acts, what is it? Acts 2. And verse 41 says that they get glad to receive the word. You can't do nothing with people that don't want to do nothing.
That's right, Father.
That's right.
And we need to encourage our boys and girls to get the best education that they can. But if you got to force your boy, force your girl to go to school, they won't learn too much. You just wasting your money. You get up early in the morning, taking them to school. Are you with
me? Yeah.
They have to want to be.
That's right, Father.
They that gladly receive the word were baptized. Reason.
Walk as children of light, for the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness.
Christian ought to walk in the light.
Amen.
Walk in their life. All right.
And truth.
Walk in the truth.
Amen.
If you tell a lie today, and 6 months down the road, you got to think about what lie you told the couple of
minutes.
But if you tell the truth, you don't have to go to walk.
No, it's wrong.
Tell the truth. They may hate you for telling the truth.
That's
oh,
right.
Yeah.
Some of us would be better off if we didn't have some people in our lives.
Help us out.
That's why I'm telling you something that you ought to have a meaningful relationship.
Mm-hmm.
A meaningful. You mean tell me you got a friend and they want to encourage you when you talk about I don't want to go to church?
Mm-hmm.
No. Dr. Blackburn and I, we don't have to talk about it. When one of us got ready to do some foolish thing, he said, no, brother, you can't do that.
That's right.
You need somebody who's stronger than you.
That's right. That's right.
Two people that's drowning can't help the other. See, somebody needs to stay on the banks.
Amen.
At least you can throw a stick or either string out there and try to pull them.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And so if I don't want to come to church, what do you think I'm going to get with? What do you think I'm going to tell Brother Law? Brother Law, we don't need to go to church.
That's right. That's right.
Jesus repeated himself over and over. You're trying to drive a point home. Is that right? We know God.
Proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness.
Have no fellowship. Right on the board. Have no fellowship. With what?
The unfruitful works of darkness.
Unfruitful people.
Yeah.
Sometimes we like we want to hang out with the unfruitful. See, when you start saying hanging out, you say, I want a husband, I want a wife. See, when the world gets ready for a wife, usually they come where? To the church. Now they may find out something when they get here. That might have been better if I had got one from the nightclub. Because there's some people in the church that get out cursed. They're hard cursed. You so and so. Now the way that you speak to each other.
That's right.
Read on.
But rather reprove them, for it is a shame even to speak of those things which are done of them in secret.
It's a shame.
Yes, sir.
Some of the things that we do, sinners would dare. You read that right there on board. I become the close tonight. See, we ought to learn to thank God.
Amen.
And renew our strength in Him.
That's right.
Romans 8:28 reminds us tonight that all things work together for good to them that love God and according to His purpose. You'll be able to realize that whatever I'm going through, that God has a reason and a purpose for it. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
So Thanksgiving brings us, into a place of rest and renewal. Then you read Isaiah 40:31.
Baby's
in the bed with you. That baby keep tossing and turning. By the time you get ready to go to sleep, you're afraid that you're going to tell the old lady. See, when we were coming up, they used to put us in a cardboard box in a drawer. And now you're going to put your husband out of bed and put the dog in the bed with you and the baby. Read verse 9 and 10 again.
He maketh wars to cease until the end of the earth.
He maketh wars to cease. All right.
He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God.
God is trying to tell us something.
Amen. God is talking to
you. He's speaking loud and clear.
Amen.
He's saying that no matter who comes up or what, whatever they come up with, they still can't solve the problem. I'm the only one who can solve the problem.
Amen.
Is that right? See, Jesus said, I am the greater one. Is that right? I'm the good shepherd. See, you got to learn how to trust him.
Amen.
Thank you, man. The psalmist David. The psalmist David, in the midst of conflict, he wrote this, Psalm 103. Psalm 103. What do you do when you are in the midst of conflict?
Right.
All right.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Amen. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to complain. But I'm going to bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Bless the Lord. Read it.
And all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
See, you can forget the benefits of God if you don't stay in the church. You stay around people that are talking negative. When you know anything, you're doing the same thing that they do. See, you got to be reminded. Yeah. That's what Isaiah said. Hezekiah said, Lord, you remember. And when you start thinking about all the good things that God has done for you,
amen,
you find yourself not complaining.
Amen.
I could have been dead, buried in my grave.
Oh, yeah.
But you may go see them. Read on.
Who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from the destruction.
All right, number one, thank you. God can heal all manner of diseases. Mm-hmm. Number two, God can solve your problem and mine at the same time. America needs to be saved. America needs to turn to God and confess that the Lord, I've been wrong in my life.
Yes, yes.
And I need some divine help. And when we realize that we need some divine help, go to Psalm 34, I believe. Psalm 34. Right there on the board, that God is our refuge. God is our refuge.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
This is what the psalmist said. I will. See, you. Sometimes our praises depend on what somebody else did.
Mm-hmm.
You got to learn to pray to God for yourself.
Amen.
And that's what David said. He said what?
I will bless the Lord at all times.
I will bless the Lord at all times. If you don't focus on the negative thing, but the good thing, you find yourself praising God no matter where you are.
Amen.
You got to learn how to think.
Amen.
You know? All right.
My soul shall make her boast in the Lord.
My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. All right.
The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Mm-hmm. Oh, magnify the Lord.
He said, oh, magnify. You almost got the big people to say amen today. Got the big people to go to church. In the little church that we came up, people would be going down the dusty road going to church. At 8 o'clock in the morning, the road would be filled with people going to church. You didn't have no Cadillac, no Mercedes Benz, but wagons and walking on in the dust and on the rocks. We were glad when they said, let us go to the...
Amen.
You got it too easy today.
Sometimes, Beth, somebody would strike up a song while they walk. They would strike up a song while they walk.
Yeah, somebody would start singing a song. And when you know anything, 15 to 24 would be singing a song. Going down the road. Going down the road. We want to sing. We want to sing the blues song. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so.
Amen, Father.
What does it say?
And let us exalt his name together.
Let us exalt his name
together.
Read.
I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto me and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all of his troubles.
All right, thank you, man. God will hear. I cry.
Yes, he will.
God will hear our moan. God will come to see our life.
Yes.
We got to learn how to depend on God, trust God, and give him all the praise and glory. Thank you so very much for having two men to our teaching session on this Wednesday night. And we trust that you have been helped and encouraged, that if you're in the area of Buffalo, stop by 77 Humboldt Parkway at the Memorial Baptist Church, and then at 318 High Street in Buffalo. And we'd be glad to have you to share with us. And here in Toledo, 2102 Mulberry Street, where everybody is somebody. Thank you so kindly for being here. Don't forget, tomorrow, prayer meeting and brother funeral services at